My name is Fernando, aka FK Piano Man, and today I'm going to show you how to improve your sound instantly with this relatively cheap device that's just a little bit more than a standard SM58 stage mic. So, let's go. Are you performing solo but worried your sound is a bit empty? Do you lack confidence with your singing? Or perhaps you don't like your voice? This device will instantly improve your sound, and I'm going to show you three things that it does. Number one, the tone button. This little button provides a little bit of EQ, smooths out the voice, gives you a nice tone. If you don't have any equalizer on your mixer, or you don't have a mixer and you just plug this straight into your PA speaker, great little function to use. I personally prefer to use equalizer on the mixer, but it's up to you, especially if you're starting out and you want to plug straight into your speaker and not carry a lot of gear around. Great little unit to have, does all your vocal processing straight into a speaker, good to go. Number two, reverb. Great little feature on it. When I started out performing solo, I relied quite heavily on the reverb, not being very comfortable with my voice. Quite a bit of reverb seemed to soften the harshness and the mistakes, slight detunes, lack of breath in my singing. But as I got better and I developed a bit more technique, I dropped that reverb down and just put a little bit, just so it's wet and not too dry. Gives a nice softness to the voice. Great little feature to have as well. And the big one, number three, harmony. Adding some light harmonies here and there adds some color, variety, and interest to your sound. It's also great for covering some of your vocal imperfections as well. I certainly use it when I have to do some difficult parts. I put a bit of harmony in there and it softens away any lack of ability, let's say, in my vocal chops. And there are several modes to pick. I'm going to show you two modes today. For the first mode I'm going to show you, which is this position here, which is a harmony above and below my voice. I'm going to show you a little snippet of Candle in the Wind, where I use it sparingly, just to highlight little accents.
Even when you die, oh, the prayers to haunted you, all the papers had to say, was in Maryland, was found in the new. Seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would like to know you, but I was just a kid. Candle burnt out long before the legend that it did.
The second mode is this one, which is one harmony below my voice. I'm going to show you a little snippet of a Simon and Garfunkel tune, The Sound of Silence. I love this song and have never been able to play it as a soloist because you really need that second harmony. Just have a listen at how good this little unit reproduces a second harmony live on the spot.
Hello darkness, my old friend, I've come to talk with you again, because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was
How does it work? Your signal from your instrument, guitar, piano, keyboard, comes in through here and then goes back out through there. Your voice signal comes in as well and then it goes back out. So as your signal comes in to the unit will then analyze what you're singing and what you're playing and will adjust and create a harmony accordingly. You've got a harmony setting here, so you can pick 8 different settings on different harmonies. One harmony above, one below, one above and below, close and far away. Your level for your harmonies, how loud do you want the harmonies to be? And also 3 reverb settings, where you can adjust how loud or low you want the reverbs. Club, hall, or room reverb. And last of all, the tone button. And how do you activate it? You just press it on and off with your foot. I like to keep it here next to my stand because when I'm playing the piano, I don't have to look down and I know that it's right next to my stand. So if I need to activate it, I just go near my foot pedal and I know I'll always hit it. There is one small gripe that I have about this unit, and it's that the knobs are very close to the pedal. So there are times when I'll press the pedal and I can accidentally adjust the knobs. Other than that, it's a great unit for the price that it is. And a point to note, even though it is marketed towards guitarists and it does have a picture of an actual guitar on it, it works really well with pianos and keyboards. Make sure to practice before you take this unit on a gig with you. I have been unfortunate enough to see someone try one of these out of the box on stage without any practice. And it does take a little bit of tweaking to find out what works and what doesn't. It does work with most songs, but once you get to a bit more complicated, more jazzy chords, that's where it gets a little bit tricky. Sometimes simplifying the way you play or slight adjustments, you'll find the harmonizer will pick up chords much better. If you have a bit of cash to splash, TC Helicon also makes a range of higher end vocal harmonizers with a bunch of effects and more. I also use the TC Helicon Voice Live 3 Extreme, and that has a bunch more vocal effects. It also includes live looping capabilities, which I will demonstrate in a video where I play a song of Beyoncé's Crazy in Love in my descriptions here. Thanks for watching. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and don't forget to turn on your notifications so you can find out when my next videos are on. And you can show your support by liking this video as well. And feel free to leave any comments, questions, or suggestions for any future videos. I'll see you next time. My name is Fernando, aka F Key Piano Man. Take care.